9 stages. I have no idea what this actually is, if it's like an escape room type thing or what. Let's see if I can figure it out. Cheese or not. I am not lactose intolerant, so I can consume as much cheese as I want. Oh yeah, I remember this. I remember this. I checked out the start of this last time, but I had no idea what to do other than push these things over. Oh my god! Whoopa! Oh my god, so crazy. Anyway, what am I actually doing here? What am I doing? What? Blue ball. Something. Red button? I'm so confused already. Red button. That's the red button. Okay. Wait, what? Yeah, this is a build area. What am I doing in the build area? So wait, if this is a build area, can I take this apart. Why am I allowed to do this? What does this mean? What does any of this mean? I can't pick up this light. I can't, like, take this apart. But I can do whatever I want with a vehicle, apparently. Oops, I took a logic gate out. Uh-oh. Uh-oh, I hope I didn't break it. Uh-oh. So this is already as fast as it can go. Where's the seat? What am I doing here? Take this off. Okay, I'm pretty sure I'm not supposed to be doing any of this. But I don't know what to do at this point. What does this mean? Tell me what it means. So I see the sensor. I see this sensor. This is probably the start challenge sensor, and it gets triggered by something underneath, right? Like right those bars. There's even a spot for a lift, but I don't have the lift. What does this mean? Well, I can take off all of this stuff that's like, looks like it's superfluous. Hopefully I don't break anything. Lots of sensors, what? So I just took off colored blocks that are probably on colored sensors. Wait a second. Yeah, it is in color mode. Purple? Purple was the color? What? Okay, where do I... Oh wait, I just have a paint tool. Doi. Let's put the plastic back. How is anyone supposed to figure this out? What? Okay, so it's a ball picker-upper. Seems to still be working even though it's missing a logic gate. What am I doing here? What has challenge mode become right now? Let's take a peek inside. Sensors that spin around, timers and stuff, a pipe on a bearing that spins to literally do nothing. What is happening? What is this challenge? I can't even tell what color that is because of this darn build area. I mean, let's take more stuff apart. What if I do something like... What is this? I can't affect that sensor, so... But I guess I can put stuff here. And... guess every single color that it can be. It's not that. It's not that. Cause it's not being triggered with something right in front of it, so even if it was range zero, it would be activated. So I know for sure that it's color mode. Is that even in front of the sensor? I have no idea. Okay, that's definitely covering the sensor. Which color would it be? It has to be a paint color, right? Yeah, it only gives you the paint color options. The color of the bottom? I guess so, right? Just block? Yeah, okay, that starts the challenge. To do what exactly? I can't... Uh-oh. I can't paint anything anymore. I have no idea what's going on. I can't tell what this is either. So let's go ahead and take all of this. This we're taking. We're taking this. We're taking all of this. Just taking as much building material as I can. Without, like, breaking stuff, I hope. I hope I'm not breaking stuff. I'm pretty sure I can take all of this. What? What am I doing? Okay, well, I'll take all of this. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Okay, I could just paint that to start the challenge anytime. That's kind of good. This is probably, like, more cheese than what I'm actually supposed to be doing. Follow this block all the way back here. It's right on top of the sensor. Oh, what? Oh, no, that's just because I ran out of blocks. So, technically, I can still keep building. Yes. Yes. This might just be cheese. I have no idea what the range of this is. Gosh, no idea. Let's try black. Okay, that's working. That's working. Oh, what? What? No, why aren't you triggering the finish? Okay, I got it. What? What even is this? All right. Who needs to actually play the challenge when you can just cheese it? Seriously, I have no idea. Red, left turn, green, right turn. So, like, I can't paint anything down here. Oh, you know what? First of all, component kits. I can always take those. Alright, so I'm starting to understand something. I think I get the challenge finally. I think you do this. It doesn't explain anything, though. It doesn't explain what color means go. You know? I thought that was gonna left turn or right turn. I'm so confused. Wasn't it purple? Purple is pickup. Let's get all this out of here for a second. They're all purple. Where did I see it? I thought one of them was blue. Yeah, okay, there's a red, a light red. This one is light blue. Okay, I think I'm starting to understand. Light blue. Aha! Aha! Okay. Yeah, I definitely got the record. Oh, wait, what? Wait, what? Don't tell me I gotta do the same thing. Don't tell me I gotta find a way to cheese again. I will do it. I'm just trying to do this legit, you know? What? Let's take all this out of here again. So lots of purple, a blue, there's the red. It's just blue and red. Where's the green come in? I have the component kits in my hotbar, yet they are here. You know what that means, right? Infinite component kits. 10 component kits. What is this? What is this? I have infinite material to build with, to cheese with. Are you kidding me right now? All right. How many component kits do you think it takes? All right, well, I have plenty of component kits. I don't even need to take this thing apart. here we go. Can I paint this? There we go. And the end's right there. this is so broken. Not even a second. Not even a second. Beat that. I still don't understand what this challenge is supposed to be. Anyway, the whole thing about any component kits here? Ball spawner, I finally get to pick up the ball, even though I'm not actually gonna pick it up. So is this just put the ball in the receiver and that's the end? Like I understand purple is the yellow is reverse. Dude, you don't give me the colors. You don't even give the sensors the color mode that they need to do the instructions you're telling me to do. There's blue, purple, red. It's just the same sensor array every time. Are there more sensors that I don't know of? Like, not here there isn't. There's no seat on this. There's nothing. There's nothing that I can actually do with this. Dude, I'm so lost. I'm just gonna cheese every single challenge. Every single challenge, I'm gonna cheese. How do I start this challenge, though? Oh, wait, yeah. Okay, I think I can do this. But yeah, the thing about design is that it's a much better way of designing. If you build... Gosh, I don't even know how to say it. I'm gonna go, like, way out on a crazy limb, because a lot of people like to try to make AI. Oops, I need to paint it black. And there's even, like, a thing called a Turing test, where, you know, if you're chatting with a chatbot on the internet, and you don't recognize that it's a bot, then technically it passed the Turing test. Like, you're fooled. You might as well think that you're talking to a human. But if it's very obviously a chatbot, then it failed the Turing test. And that's... Why am I even on this topic right now? I'm too busy cheesing this challenge. Oh my gosh. Hey, I got a ladder now. I mean, I can just take it apart. And a thing with buttons. Okay. You're supposed to pick that up. Is that... Uh-oh. This looks like the first one that I can't actually cheese. Or is it? Wait, what? Is this as high as it goes? Here? Oh, I know I can get that. It might still be doable. Even though I don't know how to operate this vehicle, I could still possibly do this. There we go, I got that switch. It doesn't open the doors or what? Is there another switch up here? There is! Oh, I don't know if I can do this. Okay, looks like we're gonna be able to do it. Just after a long time. So basically, the reason why just build stairs up, you know, that's something that I could totally do too. It gave me a ladder too. I'm a little bit of a dingus. Give me all this. Give me that. I'll use that. You know, I can even take the wheels, too. I'll take all the pipes. Oops, I just took the wheel off. Let's just start building this. I think I have enough blocks now. But, like, the number logic parts... You can, they're individual components, right? Get it? Components? They're individual components that allow you to do stuff. Maybe, yeah, okay, now that it's back up, let's put a little leg on it. There we go. There we go. There There we go. So yeah, that's why I was saying, like, the component kits are sort of like a lazy shortcut towards the end goal. Where somebody was definitely sitting in the office and, like, smirking to themselves for, you know, having done something great. Like, I guarantee you the developers actually think that component kits are an amazing idea. And they're not. For the same reason... Yeah, for the same reason. It's just that, like, there's very... It doesn't... Ugh, I don't know how to explain it. It just doesn't add to the game in the same way that a properly designed part would. The idea for, like, any survival game, or sandbox game for that matter, you want each component to actually add to the gameplay experience. And so component kit is a lot more like a currency, like dollars, where they don't, they're, you know, they're just sort of like universally applicable. And that's kind of like exactly the reason why I'm sure the developers think they did a good thing, is like, oh yeah, we did this cool universally applicable component called a component kit. Except that there's no reason for it to exist. For, you know, for people to think that, like, oh, now I gotta pull out a component kit and build with it. When it would be much better to have, like, all of the crafting recipes and everything that you gotta upgrade. Speaking of which, 5 upgrade levels is completely unnecessary. Like, that was literally just something that they copied off of an old mod. It's so... The state of this game is ridiculous. But yeah, it's just like, this being a universal component like that, it doesn't actually add to the player's experience. Oh, I went too far that time. There we go. Where's the end? There's the end. Now I gotta go out and back in. And back in? Got it. Got it. 4.2. Glad to hear that, I don't even know how to finish that sentence. Glad to hear you didn't die from COVID. Like, what? What was I gonna say with that? I'm glad to hear that you're all right. Jeez. Social awkwardness shining through. Don't mind me. Durf, if you see this, say this. Never gonna give the cheese. Never going to left the cheese. Never gonna run the cheese and desert the cheese. Is that supposed to be like a Rickroll, but like with cheese? I don't think you even got the lyrics of the Rickroll right. Never gonna give the cheese. Never gonna left the cheese. I don't know what that means, left the cheese. A cheese roll. You know, a cheese roll is a real thing, you know? Yeah, no? Okay, we got a sensor up there this time. What is this? An engine? Component kit! Oh, it's an explosive! And that's an elevator. Elevator. What is the purpose of this elevator? No. That's a really high elevator. Can I move it? No, it's attached to the wall. Can I move the stool? I cannot. Ham. Something tells me, like, do I need to flip that switch? Do all these sensors need to be activated? Something tells me. Okay, see, like, I don't activate this sensor, no matter what. So something's telling me to just do the exact same thing that I did before. Yoink. I might be able to beat this entire challenge pack without even playing it properly. Get all these blocks are mine. Okay, I think I can take even more blocks, even more pipes. I don't think I need this much stuff anyway, but I'm gonna take it. So yeah, when I see something like the component kit, I think it's like some of the worst design in any sandbox game, survival game, ever. Like, ever. Like, it takes away from potential gameplay and potential hours that people would spend. Crafting recipes should just be parts that people work for, like, in the game. You know, you don't have to... It would make upgrade levels more valuable if, for example, to build an electric engine, you had to use a lot of metal and maybe a little bit of stone, or, I don't know, even toss some water in there, or, like, some ember. Whatever the crafting recipe for the electric engine is. And then for level 2 electric engine, which, if anything, there should just be 2 levels or 3 levels max. 5 levels is way too much. Alright, let's see. Let's hope this is just the end. Okay, that's just a giant elevator. And I only needed to activate it once. Okay. Okay, and then the thing... Okay, bridge activates. That's the goal? Uh-oh. I can't deactivate this, even if I wanted to. Uh-oh, Spaghetti-O. Well... What does that do? Does that open the area? Or what? I guess I still have enough blocks to do something about that. I might still be able to save this. Two blocks here. Okay, wait. There we go. Yeah, so upgrade levels, I think, instead of component kits, if they were just using actual crafting recipes, then that would add more value to each upgrade level. Like, players would actually have to work for the next level. You know what? I could just jump over. The problem now is, do I have enough parts to get back? I think I do. Okay. Ah! Ah! Yeah, and if each upgrade level, like, cost you twice the resources of the previous level, then that's... It's not... It, okay, that... That also might be, like, that might end up being an annoying kind of, that might be, like, a tedious experience, and that's also something that you don't want to design. That's why I say, like, a lot of the reasons, a lot of the best designs are something that is, like, a byproduct of what you programmed. You don't want to chase that end result, and that's what you're seeing a lot of with Scrap Mechanic. And, like, the things like component kits, like, they had an idea, and they're just, like, chasing that end result without any actual thought about what it does, oh my gosh, to the player's experience. Because, like, they had... What did it do? The wire goes up here, but, like, what does it do? How do you get to the goal? I might still just be able to build to the goal. But, like, that switch didn't do anything. Alright, I might still be able to save it. Yeah, okay. I can reach all these parts. Get them all back. Yeah, we can just leave that there. As a matter of fact, we can already start building. Straight to the end. I also have to make sure that I have enough to get back up the other way. Oh my gosh. Yeah, kind of a sketchy ladder that I'm climbing up here. But that's what I need to do. I can barely fit over top. I think that's just luck. I think that's just luck that I can even do that. How many more parts do I have? I can get back up if I need to. My gosh. Emergency situation is like, build something, detach part of it, and then like, kick it around until it's on there. So if I really need to get back up, I can have this pipe ladder. Is that even gonna work? Yeah, okay, it works pretty darn good. Pretty darn good. Okay. Oh. Alright. Alright. Looking like... like, this can't possibly be the challenge. See there? alright, here we go. World record. World record. Here. 0.3! What stage am I on? Every single stage I've cheesed. I have not played a single stage of this challenge correctly. Yeah, if you haven't been here for the start of the challenge, you're supposed to, like, paint the side of this some color for this vehicle to do something, like drive forward or pick up a ball or something. Let's go ahead and paint it that purple so you can see. Purple? Oh, I also gotta turn it on. There you go. So, like, this is a function of the thing to pick something up. There's another color that you can paint to you know, for it to drive forward, turn left, turn right. Except that as soon as it drives out of the area, like as soon as the challenge starts, you can't paint this anymore. So I don't know how to actually play this challenge properly. So what I've been doing instead is just taking it apart, rip, taking all these blocks, and just building off of the base that's left behind. And that's how I've been getting around and getting to places. Checkmark? Checkmark? I have no idea. Check mark is blue, that's green. So do these need just blue and green stuff? I have no idea. This is a, okay, loose thingy. I can't take those apart. Red, a red thingy that I can pick up. Refinery. Okay, so is this, I put the red thingy in here, I get the green thingy. I get the green thingy, put it here, get the blue thingy, put the blue thingy here. Molder, refinery molder. There's like some lore too that I'm not paying attention. And then this door opens too, uh-oh, this door opens? Does it actually open? This door doesn't even open. This door also doesn't even open. Does this move at all? Nope. Does this move? Nope. Okay, so what you see is what you get. Nothing too crazy about this challenge. Just gotta cheese it some more. Yes. Alright, so let's just get started with some cheese. I've gotten so used to taking this thing apart now. Derv, can you play Stormworks soon? Yes. I have installed Stormworks. Or I think I already had it installed, but it's up on the list as one of the next games I'm gonna be playing. Same with Roboco. I want to revisit some Roboco. I either want to try that Across the Goo challenge and try to get all the secrets, or just play some sandbox, building some stuff. Yeah, soon, TM. Little asterisk there. Soon can mean anything, like next century. All depends on the context of... Like, I'm sure there was a dinosaur that was just like, an asteroid's gonna hit soon. And all the other dinosaurs were just like, yeah, okay. And then like a couple, you know, dozen generations later, they're like, oh my god, our forefathers were right. Soon. What a stupid way of defining soon. Should be able to get all of this here too. these big old boys in the back. I've got plenty of material now. Plenty of material. Let's just start building. Start the building. Which block? I'm gonna make the best use of my blocks that I can. Okay, you're green? Uh-oh. You're not black, are you? Maybe it's just the distance. Yeah, we'll just build that out of blocks. Whatever. Except that now I can't tell. Now I cannot tell. How do I see what I'm doing here? Fine, we'll just waste a bunch of blocks to do this. Like this. Like that. Okay, now I can see what I'm doing. Black is not the color. Green is not the color. Light green is not the color. Red is the color. Red, duh, because the border was red. Oh. I don't even know what was going on under there. Uh-oh. I hope I didn't need to... Okay, never mind. Never mind, it got me the... Ha! Because the challenge didn't start, it didn't detach. Or did it? I don't know. It doesn't... destructible blocks aren't destructible. Unless the timer started. So where is the start timer then? Oh yeah, duh, it's right here. Like it always is. Okay. Okay, I think we'll be able to do this. Got plenty of material. You know, there's also something that I can just do, now that I have plenty of stuff. Let's just do it and show you what I'm talking about. Probably a much easier, or I should say cheaper way of doing this. Cheaper as in, like, saves on resources. You know, actually, let's just use some of the big stuff that I have. Why not? Yes. It's a funky shape like this. And then we paint all of this green. And we can just detach it. And then run into it. Okay, that's not where you're supposed to go, but pretty close. Uh-oh. Uh-oh, don't tell me you're not moving anymore. Oh, not that way, not that way. Well, it does save on parts. I'm pretty sure I have plenty of parts to do this anyway. Here. Oh, almost got it. Almost got the hole in one. I think, oh wait, I can just build off this. All right, well, I guess I did it anyway. So wait, I can detach a thing. Kick it around and then... Okay, so there's a blue thing with a duck on it. There's no other special sensor or anything, right? So it's just these sensors down here that need something blue, right? 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 All right, let's try it out then. Just build myself a cube. Paint it blue. All right. Uh-oh. This is probably not the best design. Uh-oh. Yeah, it just tilts over and then I walk up it. Maybe not a good idea to do it like this. Or maybe it is. Or maybe it is. What? I feel like though I'm a little kid and like those little things that it's basically like a suspended seat with like wheels around it. Little kid bounces around on it. They might have like a little table to go with it. Kind of like a hamster ball. I don't think they make hamster balls for toddlers. Ah, there we go. Now all we gotta do is start the challenge. This is... I haven't played a single one of these challenges properly. And I'm loving it. I'm loving it so far. Here we go. Record time. Huh. Oh, I didn't get the record time. 0.4 seconds. You have round blocks. Why not make it a little more round and roll it? Oh, you know what? I should have done that. All right, let's see what we got this time. Three balls. Volleyball balls. They seem to be pretty stuck. Can you attach a ball onto stuff? Yeah, you can, right? So this might be one of those ones where I have to actually start the challenge. What is that? What is this stage? The stage is different. I'm scared. Am I gonna be able to cheese it? But like, from what I can tell, those balls are not loose. Actually, you know what? We can test it with the third-person camera trick. Okay, they are loose. They are loose, because if they were built... No, wait. They might still be on a piston or something. I don't know if they're actually... Gosh darn diggity darn dang do. I don't know how to go about doing this one. I could use wedges. That is something that I can do. Okay. Not a whole lot of pipes, but we can get more. As a matter of fact, you know, since I'm not ever playing this challenge correctly, why do I even care about preserving the logic on this vehicle? Right? I could just build out of logic gates. Okay, let's see what we can do. There you go. Just push it with my body. That works. Lots of heavy metal. Like that. Maybe some more wedges on top. Okay, what happens if I detach this? Nothing. A whole lot of nothing. Okay, well, thankfully I can still pick all this up. Am I gonna be able to cheese it? Durf, have you met yourself? What are you saying? What are you saying? That I'm a very cheesy person? That I make cheesy jokes? That I've got a lot of cheat? Never mind, I'm not gonna say the last part. I don't know if anyone knows what I was about to say. Foot cheese is another kind of cheese. That I got a lot of foot cheese. I suppose I am pretty good at cheesing stuff, but like from what I can tell right now, I have no idea how to get this stuff off. Okay, some wedges this way. All right. Just some regular old dwarf power. The balls are not attached in any way. Looking pretty good so far. I'm kind of surprised a dwarf can even push this. Stinky cheese is another one, yeah. Has anyone ever actually eaten stinky cheese? What is the purpose? What is the value in your cheese being stinky? How does that make it tastier? I think you're completely full of yourself. You've convinced yourself that it's somehow fancier to eat stinky cheese. Do you even realize, like, cheese is basically milk gone bad? Especially blue cheese, it's mold! Alright, so we've pretty much gotten the red ball out of this. I don't know if we're actually making progress anymore. Okay, yeah. We're making progress. Just roll on in. Okay, I guess we still gotta start the challenge for that to count. I think one thing that we can do is just take... Did I get a bearing from that? No, the bearing must be in here. Okay, cool. A couple bearings, cool. Okay, we're gonna basically do the same thing, but on a bearing this time. I think that will work a little bit better. Yeah. Actually, if I build it too heavy, I don't know if I'm gonna... Well, it's the same weight. I don't know what I was so worried about. But yeah, I don't know if I'm gonna be able to, turn the thing. The golf club, essentially. But I don't think I have to worry about that, since all the weight was already on the vehicle. The first time that I did this. And I already have this stack of 10 wedges, I don't need this. And plus, this is the only rotation that I'm doing. Right here. Right here. Okay, let's see how this works. Yeah, much better. Way better. Way better. Too bad I don't have a weld tool for this, huh? Then I could just cut that off and weld it. I am just cheesing every stage of this challenge. It turned out to be a lot more fun to not do this I still don't know how to do this challenge properly. But so far, every single stage, I've cheesed. Every single one of them, I have not played this challenge properly. And I'm having fun. I'm having lots of fun doing it. Get on in there. Get on in there. There you go. There you go. This is definitely not what you're supposed to be doing on this challenge. Yeah, I think that'll work. Alrighty, here we go. Uh-oh. Oh no, okay. Super easy peasy. We got it. Come on. Come on now. Come on now. Kind of a bad building position that I did, but we got it. Here. Oh my god, it might be possible for me to fall through that. Now we're just playing golf without a hammer. Okay. Okay, that's not... Oh my god, okay. We might need to do a little bit of juggling here at the end, but I think we're good to start. No speed run attempt this time. There you go. Yeah. There's the green ball. There's the red ball. And the blue ball. And now we run to the finish. Yeah, 21 seconds. All right. I'm set to complete this entire challenge. What does this do? Oh gosh, does it start both of them? One button to start two vehicles. I have twice as much building material. I'm just thinking about how I can cheese this better. Nothing really to do with this shelf, as far as I can tell. Paint bucket. Well, what is the purpose? What is the purpose of this? That's where the goal is. Okay, so it's just another sensor to get... Oh, wait, what? Uh-huh. Okay, so that can get me up there. I can definitely soft lock myself under there. That's gonna get me into that area, but I don't think I really need to worry about that. I think we're gonna do exactly what I did a couple stages ago. Exactly the same thing. This is definitely an unintended petition to rename this challenge back to Sharp Cheddar. Yeah, I don't remember whose challenge this was. Automation Inc. on the workshop. It's definitely meant to be like, you paint the stuff and it's automated. And I'm definitely ruining it by playing it with lots of cheese. But that's more because I have no idea how to actually play it. Yeah, no hammer or spud gun for me. I'm not gonna be picking anything up, right? So let's just not worry about all of this on top. Or on the sides. Alright, I was able to get a lot from this. Without it completely falling apart. This is a loose piece now, but I don't think I really need wedges. Not in this one anyway. Okay, plenty of blocks, and then there's another vehicle entirely, if I really need more. So let's, where's the start? There's two starting sensors, is there? Two of them? Two of them? I gotta activate both of them? Let's test it out. No, either one of them starts the challenge. Uh-oh. Uh-oh, that's a bad thing. Uh-oh, that's a bad thing. Uh-oh. Alright, so I gotta restart this stage. Everything I did, I gotta do over again. Real quickly, dismantle, dismantle. You see dismantle over here? On my, above my fireplace or whatever? Dismantle is my mantle. I haven't needed any one of these vehicles ever. Not even once. So I might as well just take everything. The problem is I do need a starting point to build from, so I can't completely delete it. Alright, I can still build off this one. I think we're okay. Wheels are pretty big parts. They can come in handy. Lots of timers too. Engines are a pretty big part. Yeah, let's take the timers. There you go. There you go. So anytime that I want to start the challenge, bada bing, bada boom. Now, for the rest of this challenge, I can just do a little thing that I did before. There we go. We'll just start building off of that. I gotta get to the goal and back, presumably. So getting up there shouldn't be too bad, because I just gotta get something on top of here. So I just need to get a building ladder on the other side of this wall. Something on the other side of that wall. Just like this. Okay, so now when I actually trigger the sensor. Okay, yeah. Trigger the sensor from over here. But yeah, even if the challenge is started, I can just use the elevator to get up here, jump to this area. Oh, there's even a ramp. Kind of a dangerous ramp here. And that's where the finish platform is, from what I can see. So maybe I should start the challenge. But I can't see the blocks yet. There we go, now I should be able to see them. Alright. Yeah. Super easy. Oh, I fell in. And I'm locked out? Oh wait, I'm not locked out. I'm locked out! I'm not locked out. Oh, they're just in switch mode. Boop. Boop. Oh, shoot. Okay. Oh wow, super easy now. Dude, I just should have jumped down and that's it. I can continue this without worry. Is that all I need to do? Yep, and that's where the finish is. Paint this and enter the finish. Got it. Gobble. Honestly, I love this challenge. Cheesing the entire thing is a lot of fun. How I was actually supposed to play it, I have no idea. So lots of explosives that I can only trigger when the challenge starts. Up there, no idea what that is. Down here, explosives, a battery, which I can just take. Oh gosh, okay, so I can always explode this. anytime that I want. Maybe that's supposed to explode after it drives down. Yeah. So I can't paint this, though. So how am I supposed to get that to drive? What does this do? Oh, that's just another elevator. Can't I just... Yeah, this is a loose elevator, so let's just push it. Whoop. Where do I push it? There's so many places to go. The side button? What, you think it just starts automatically? Oh, that's what the spud gun is. Oh, it's a red... Okay. Yeah. All right, well, I'm racing the clock right now. Yeah. Uh-oh. There's a red cable somewhere from there, so I'm guessing I was supposed to activate that at some point. And then a blue cable. Uh-oh. I mean, I might have to restart this one anyway, but uh-oh. I gotta hurry up. Gotta start the challenge. Challenge is started. Okay, so when that gets over here, something's gonna happen. I mean, I could just trigger these myself, right? Just by landing on them very, very roughly. Running into them kinda stupidly. Not really, huh? If I had like a loose piece of something, I could toss the elevator into it. Ah, it's gonna get there anyway. What is even up there? A couple switches? Oh, there's the finish. Alright, I didn't even need to do that hardcore parkour. I think what I did for the hardcore parkour was to activate the spud gun, which activated the driving anyway. Man, the entire challenge pack. Automation Inc. by Randomness69. That's the same person that made the plane trials. What? How do you make such a frustrating challenge and then such an awesome challenge accidentally? That's crazy.